देखो Good afternoon to one and a.
Good afternoon.
Good Okay, shall we start today's lesson? So today we will discuss about that block diagram, transmitter block diagram of adaptive delta modulation, receiver block diagram of adaptive delta modulation. Okay. So what is the importance of adaptive delta modulation? In adaptive delta modulation, the step size is adaptive. That is, according to that modulating signal, the quantization error, that is the difference between modulating signal and quantized signal, step size signal, is more. According to that quantization error, here the step size is increased and decreased. That is the important feature of adaptive delta modulation. So due to that one, here we can reduce the slope overload distortion, at the same time granular noise also. Okay, so now I will share my screen and I will explain the block diagram, operation of that block diagram. Okay. All of you, my screen is visible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
So please note down this block diagram, transmitter block diagram. So here the input is modulating signal, the sample version of the modulating signal. And here the output of the delay. And this section indicates that accumulator. And here 1-bit quantizer. And here only the difference here, one block is the logic for step size control. Here we can observe that. Logic for step size control is a one of the important block that can be present. So logic for step size control is the additional block. Here, in previous class, we observed that the step size is fixed one, but here the variable step size that can be present. The step size is variable here. please note down this block diagram. This portion below this one is called as accumulator. So all these are the accumulator. This is an accumulator. So here let us assume this is a modulating signal. Here that compare it, different signal that can be obtained at the output of this difference amplifier. Here we can positive and negative here. At the output of this difference network, this is a difference signal here, E of NDS. Let us assume initially the step size is in previous example we consider the step size is starting at plus 5 volts. Let us assume. So at the starting sample here, let us assume that is in a 3. We can store that 5 step size in this delay. Then 3 minus 5, that is in a difference signal is negative. So 1-bit quantizer is that is input to this 1-bit quantizer. 3 minus 5 minus 2. Here that is in a negative value minus 2. That is not exceeds the step size. Here whatever may be that is in given this one is in a plus 5. So that's why here we can indicate that negative. So logic for step size control here, the feedback is given to this one. Oh, that is minus 2. So only one step is necessary for downward. There is no change in that step size like that. That program is running. That is programmable. That is logic for step size control is nothing but a programmable one. Here, like that here, it decreases one step only. If that is 0 is present. Suppose if that is, then here at that accumulator, that is 0 that can be stored. Initially that is 5 stored, and then next one is 0 stored. If that is next sample is, let us assume, 10. If the next sample value is 10. But here at that one, that is a 0, it is an accumulator or the output of this delay. Next one, 10 minus 0, 10 volts. Here that can be given to this positive 10 volts, that can be given to this 1-bit quantizer. The 10 volts is far away from this step size. మనం ఎంత యాక్చువల్ గా తీసుకున్నాం, ఒక స్టెప్ సైజ్ ప్లస్ 5 వోల్ట్స్ అని తీసుకున్నాం, కానీ ఇక్కడ ఎంత వచ్చింది మనకి 10 వోల్ట్స్ అని వచ్చింది అకార్డింగ్ టు దట్ తీసుకుంటే. సో దట్ ఈస్ లాజిక్ ఫర్ స్టెప్ సైజ్కి వచ్చేటప్పటికి. సో పాజిటివ్ 10 వోల్ట్స్ అంటే సో యాక్చువల్ స్టెప్ సైజ్ కంటే సో ఇంకా ఎక్స్ట్రా 1 స్టెప్ సైజ్ ఇంక్రీజ్ చేస్తే వి కెన్ దట్ cross that modulating signal or equal to that modulating signal. Like that here, we can vary that one. The step size that can be varied from 0 to here, 1 step size 1 plus 5 volts and another 5 volts, 10 volts, that step size that can be increased and stays TS seconds. Like that here, we can observe that here we also represent that waveform like this. Waveform ganaka ganu teeskunte ganaka here.
Madam.
Ma. Wait chestunnara?
Hello cheyamantunnaru.
Ah, okay. Hello.
ఏరా
Okay. So here we can draw this one. Let us assume that waveform is like this. The step size is in here at this one. Here we can indicate that the step size here. Here at plus 5 volts or 0, and here we can compare. Here also, we can compare. This is the step size. This is a modulating signal. We can increase. This one is one time. So the difference between modulating signal and step signal is more. That's why here, every time we can compare these voltages, modulating signal voltage and these step size signal voltage. So one step, increment of one step is not sufficient. That's why here we can increase further step size. And two times manu increase chesam. Then vala em avutundi, the difference between modulating signal and step size is decreased. Like this. So like that here, according to that difference voltage, sorry, according to the difference voltage, here we can increase the step size by one step or two steps. That can be decided by this block, logic for step size control. If that is more, the difference between the modulating signal and quantized signal is in more positive value, it increases the step size by two times. Or otherwise, if that is the more difference value is more negative value, here we can decrease the step size by two times in negative side. Like that here, that logic for step size control is takes place. That is all those things that can be analyzed by this logic for step size control. Like that here, the step size that can be increased for two times or three times according to these E of NTS, this difference voltage. Like that here, we can eliminate or we can reduce that was slow power load distortion and granular noise according to this wave. So this is the importance of adaptive delta modulation. Okay, are you understand this operation of this one? Okay, andar note chestunnaru meedi. Hello, all of you?
Yes.
No, not. Next, now go for receiver section. Not just print in and next receiver section. This is the receiver block diagram. So here, whatever may be the data is transmitted, the data that can be received by receiving antenna that can be given to. So this is the first block in this receiver block diagram is again here you can observe that logic for step size control. Logic for step size control. Here in this adaptive delta modulation, the synchronization is very, very important. Synchronization means whatever the technology or logic is used at the transmitter section, the same logic is used at the receiver section. So here, whatever may be the logic used at the transmitter section, same logic that can be used for the receiver section. That is the importance of this one. Let us assume the first one is zero. So here first one is zero. Zero indicates that here in this logic for step size, only the step size is reduced minus 5 volts that can be reduced. Voltage. So zero undega, but minus 5 volts. Mano logic for step size control nunchi according to here you can take the data. That means zero undega, but here. So here we can represent this is an minus 5 volts. We can represent this is an minus 5 volts. So here we can indicate that here minus 5 volts that can be given to this one. This is a minus 5 volts. And here delay, initially here we can start at minus plus 5 volts in anukondi. Plus 5 volts start ayindi anukondi. So here initially 5 is there, minus 5, it goes to 0 voltage. The next TS here written is store, first one is a 5 and 0 vachidappudu ikkada to 0. Next one is 1. According to that example, so that can be increased by step size the 2 times, 5 into 5, 10 times. Here also we can indicate that. Next one, logic for step size control is here, we can increase 10. Here after minus 5 volts, next one is a 10. Here always here we can indicate the amplitude, that is 1. 1 into 10. Here, so that is the next one is a 10. So 10 and next one is a 0. Add these two. Again here, the step size is increased to double, plus 5 and next 5. And stays TS second. Like this here, whatever may be that step size is generated here, variable step size. The same step size is obtained at this one. The same step size is obtained at the output of this block at this one. Then this variable step sizes are the step signal is given to this low pass filter. The low pass filter output is in the smooth waveform that is corresponding to this variable step size. So that is the operation of the receiver of adaptive delta modulation. Are you understand the operation of this adaptive delta receiver, Emma? So what is the additional block that can be present in this one? Logic for step size control. Here the step size is increased and decreased according to that the error voltage or difference voltage. The difference voltage is more. Inka wait chestunnarama. If that error voltage is more positive voltage, how to increase that step size double or triple times? Or if that is in, otherwise, if that is a more negative value, the step size also decreased according to that one. 2 times decreased chayala, 3 times decreased chayala anedi telustundi. Okay. So please note down these block diagrams. Note chesukunnara? My screen is visible to you? Screen
condition? Yes, ma'am.
Not just. Ikkada enti em observe chesaru in this delta modulation? Synchronization is necessary. Synchronization. Ante manam akkada edaithe step size control use chestamo, ikkada kuda ante step size control logic anedi use cheyalam. Actually packages untay anamata. First 5 okkasari step size increase avutundi, tarvata double increase avutundi, tarvata double increase avutundi. Ivanni entante constant step sizes. Alanti mana logic manamu load chesesukoni according to that signal manu edaini use chesukochu. Ikkada programming rastam anamata. Logic for step size control is nothing but in programming. ఏదైతే మనం ట్రాన్స్మిటర్ లో ఏ ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ అయితే యూజ్ చేస్తామో అదే ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ అనేది మనం ఇక్కడ రిసీవర్ లో యూజ్ చేసుకోవాలి. అప్పుడు మనకి స్టెప్ సైజ్ అనేది ఈజీగా మనం ఇంక్రీజ్ చేయొచ్చు అకార్డింగ్ టు దట్ ఎర్రర్ సిగ్నల్. దేర్ ఫోర్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అవాయిడ్ ద స్లోప్ ఓవర్లోడ్ డిస్టార్షన్ ఇన్ దిస్ ద అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ అడాప్టివ్ డెల్టా modulation. Okay, shall I start next one? Emma, hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next one is please note down. This is a very very important delta modulation. Another one, continuously variable slope delta modulation. Andar note chestu, continuously variable slope delta modulation. So first block is a difference amplifier. For the difference amplifier, it has two inputs. One is the modulating signal or sampled version of that modulating signal. Another one is a step size signal. The output of that difference amplifier is delta of t, that is the difference signal, error signal. Emma, inka wait chestunnara?
Maralo quiet ga vachesaru.
కొంతమంది వచ్చేసారా?
Yes.
Okay, now this is an error signal. Next, this one is a modulator. And this is a pulse generator. The output of pulse generator, PI of t, pulse signal, is generates. Pulse generator generates pulse signal. Pulse modulation that can be takes place. The output of P naught of output of this modulator, P naught of t, is in pulses. Then that can be given to this input to this variable. Variable gain amplifier and RC. The combination of RC is an integrator, and the output of the integrator is input to the square law device. And that is input to this variable gain controller. Again here the integrator is present. The output of variable gain control is input to the integrator. This is an integrator. The output of the integrator is a step signal, MQ of t. ఓకే, నోట్ చేసుకున్నారమ్మా బ్లాక్ డయాగ్రామ్ ని? షల్ ఐ స్టార్ట్ ది ఎక్స్ప్లనేషన్ ఆపరేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ వన్? హలో, ఉన్నారమ్మా? హలో, ఆపరేషన్ స్టార్ట్ చేయని. ఇది ఎలా మనకి డెల్టా మాడ్యులేటెడ్ సిగ్నల్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేస్తుంది? మెయిన్ స్లో పవర్ లో డిస్టార్షన్ రిడ్యూస్ చేయడానికి ప్రాక్టికల్ గా ఇదే యూజ్ చేస్తారు అన్నమాట. సో మన ప్రీవియస్ అడాప్టివ్ డెల్టా మాడ్యులేషన్ తీసుకుంటే సింక్రొనైజేషన్ అనేది చాలా చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్ కదా. మనం ట్రాన్స్మిటర్ సెక్షన్ ఏదైతే లాజిక్ యూజ్ చేస్తామో అదే లాజిక్ ఇక్కడ రిసీవర్ దగ్గర యూజ్ చేసేయాలి. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద సింక్రొనైజేషన్ కనుక లేకపోతే మనకి కరెక్ట్ గా సిగ్నల్ మనం రీకవర్ చేయలేం. సో దట్ మీన్స్ స్లో పవర్లో డిస్టార్షన్ ఎక్కువ ఉంటే కనుక వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ అవుతుంది. సో టు ఓవర్కమ్ దట్ వన్ బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ కంటిన్యూస్లీ వేరియబుల్ స్లోప్ డెల్టా మాడ్యులేషన్. ఎప్పుడూ స్లో పవర్లో డిస్టార్షన్ లేకుండా ద స్టెప్ సిగ్నల్ ఫాలోస్ that modulating signal, original signal follow avutu manaki step signal ni transmit chestundi anamata, signals ni transmit. Chudandi ikkada the operation is like this. This is the modulating signal, the samples of the modulating signal, and compared with this MQ of T, the difference is minimum. Here the modulating signal is in samples are minimum, here also the difference signal also minimum. Then that is input to this modulator, and another input to this modulator is a pulse generator. So here at this one it produces pulses like this. So here in this one, here this indicates that reference signal, the positive amplitude is same as that negative amplitude. The positive amplitude is same as that negative amplitude. This type of pulses that can be generated. Then here the pulses are inputted to this variable gain amplifier, again that are input to this integrator. Here also we can indicate this is also integrator. So if the pulses that are input to this integrator, the output of the integrator is an DC voltage here.
Ma'am, wait chestunnara ma'am.
Wait chestunnara. Ila continuous ga vaste manam discontinue avutam. Okay. So here the pulses are input to this integrator. This is also integrator. The output of this integrator is an DC voltage. So here in this case, if that is the error is small, if that is equal positive and negative are produces, pulses are produces, therefore the DC voltage is zero. And here the square law device, whatever may be the input is given to the square law device, that can be doubled by, squared by this square law device, that is input to this variable gain amplifier. So the output of the square law device is acts as biasing to this variable gain amplifier. So if in this one the zero DC voltage, there is no biasing in this variable gain amplifier, same that pulses are given to this integrator, again that corresponding voltage that can be produced MQ of T, again it produces delta of T like this. This is the processor. Then here we can transmit the signal according to this the pulses. Here we can indicate that 1 0 like that. Here the pulses that are transmitted here, then and here let us assume the modulating signal is in peak values, that is sample values are very high or max more positive voltages or negative voltage. Let us assume more positive voltage when compared with this step size signal. Then here delta of T, the error voltage is more positive voltage, and at the output of this modulator it produces more positive pulses. Positive pulses. Here we can indicate that this is a reference. Positive pulses that can be produced. So that are input to this integrator, and here instead of this one zero voltage, it produces the corresponding positive voltage here. Corresponding positive voltage that can be produced, DC voltage at the output of the integrator. Then square law device squares this input positive voltage, squares. Then that is biasing to this variable gain amplifier. The variable gain amplifier biasing that can be increased. Therefore, here the output of this variable gain amplifier is further increased. That is given to this integrator. Therefore, here the step size, the positive voltage that can be increased. The step size, positive voltage that can be increased because of here the square law device squares this voltage. And biasing of this variable gain amplifier that can be increased. Increase chesadapudu em avutundi, whatever may be the pulses input to this variable gain amplifier, the gain that can be increased, that amplitude of the pulses that can be increased, and then can be integrated. The output of the integrator is positive voltage. Then that output of the integrator, that step size that can be increased, that is almost all equal to that modulating signal. Therefore, the error delta of t is reduced. Again, it produces the pulses. That means here, that step size here increased and decreased. That is very, very important, mq of t. Okay? And again, if the m of t is more negative voltage, delta of t is negative, then it produces the pulses are more negative pulses. More negative pulses. These are the negative pulses. These are input to this integrator. It produces negative voltage, DC negative voltage. And square law device squares this negative voltage. Again here, the biasing on this positive wave, whatever may be positive or negative at the input of square law device, squares that input voltage. Then here, this can be positive voltage. The gain or biasing on this variable gain amplifier that can be increased. Therefore, the pulses, whatever may be, that also increased in a negative side. Ela manaki increase avutundi. That is input to this integrator. So the integrator produces more negative voltage that is almost all equal to the modulating signal. So therefore, here the output, the delta of t again, that can be reduced. So here we can observe that these pulses, whatever here, these pulses are equal positive and negative, and more negative pulses, and more these are the more positive pulses, more negative pulses that are transmitted by this transmitter. Continuous variable slope delta modulator, where the transmitter is there, we can transmit these pulses. And then, so what is advantage of this one? So how we can recover these step signal by using these pulses? Here we can observe that by using these pulses only, here we generate these step signal. So mq of t is entirely depending upon these pulses. That means these pulses are processed through integrator, square law device, and variable gain amplifier and integrator. So same blocks are present at the receiver section. Same blocks. That means here we can observe that the blocks of that receiver is like this. First, here we can receive that pulses. and then that signal is first passes through ekkada first integrator output is passes through square law device. The square law device is output is given to this variable gain control amplifier. So the pulses, the received pulses is given to this variable gain control, and again the output of this one is given to this integrator. Again here you can use integrator. The output of the integrator is a step signal MQ of T. Once you know the step signal, that can be passed through low pass filter. Then you will get the original signal. Here this is an integrator, again RC integrator, and this is a nothing but a square law device. The square law device, the same blocks here we can observe that. So the by using the pulses that can be passed through integrator, this is the DC voltage that can be squared by that one, that can be used as a bias for this variable gain control amplifier that is given to integrator. Here the step size signal that can be generated according to that signal, error signal. So this is a receiver. And this is the transmitter section. So here without any synchronization, here by using that components or devices whatever used at the transmitter section, here we can use the same circuits, then we can recover the original signal. So in laboratories and practically, so this continuous variable slope delta modulation is used when compared with the conventional delta modulation and adaptive delta modulation to overcome the slope over load distortion. Okay, are you understand the operation of this one? Am I ardhamainda?
Yes, ma'am.
This is very very important. Meeru laboratory lo meeku oka experiment undi, same ide use chestaru annamata. Okay na? ఒక్కొక్క బ్లాక్ ఫంక్షనింగ్ ఏంటో తెలిసిందా? ఎందుకు మనకి స్టెప్ సైజ్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది డిక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది అనేది తెలిసిందా? మళ్ళీ అటు రిసీవర్ సెక్షన్ దగ్గర ఎలా మనం స్టెప్ సైజ్ రికవర్ చేసామో తెలుస్తుంది కదా. ఏమో ఓకే, దెన్ వీ కెన్ సమ్మరైజ్ ద పాయింట్స్. Okay, summarize the points. What are the important, what is the importance of delta modulation? Anybody? Voice nun chokla cheppandi amma, from voice.
Less bandwidth,
ma'am. Less bandwidth endukani?
Then single bits undi kabatti సింగిల్ బిట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అవుతుంది.
ఒక శాంపిల్ కి సింగిల్ బిట్ ట్రాన్స్మిట్ అవుతుంది కాబట్టి వెరీ గుడ్, సిగ్నలింగ్ రేట్ రిడ్యూస్ అయిపోతుంది, బ్యాండ్ విడ్త్ రిడ్యూస్ అవుతుంది. ఓకే, ఫ్రమ్ గర్ల్స్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద డిసడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఆఫ్ స్టాండర్డ్ డెల్టా మాడ్యులేషన్ ఆర్ కన్వెన్షనల్ డెల్టా మాడ్యులేషన్? ఫ్రమ్ గర్ల్స్ నుండి చెప్పండి గర్ల్స్ ఎనీబడి వాట్ ఆర్ ద డిస్టార్షన్స్ ఆర్ డిసడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఆఫ్ కన్వెన్షనల్ డెల్టా మాడ్యులేషన్ గర్ల్స్ ఎవరు లేరా ఏత్రి అనూహ్య అనూహ్య వెరీ గుడ్ నీకు తెలిసి చెప్పడానికి ఏమన్నామా స్లో పవర్ లో డిస్టార్షన్ అండ్ అందర్ గ్రానులర్ నాయిస్ వెరీ గుడ్ వెరీ గుడ్ దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద స్లో పవర్ లో డిస్టార్షన్ ఫ్రమ్ బాయ్స్ స్లో పవర్ లో డిస్టార్షన్ అంటే ఏంటి The slope of the step size is far away from that slope of that modulating signal. Okay, that is the slope overload distortion. Granular or ideal noise and
step size large.
The step size amplitude is far away from that modulating signal, and the modulating signal is in flat waveform. Okay, so these are the. Slope overload distortion and granular noise or ideal noise. Okay. From boys, how to overcome these two problems? Anybody from the boys side? How to overcome these two problems? Slope overload distortion and granular noise. Chappali boys. సీటు సూర్య ఉన్నావా సూర్య సూర్య ఎనీబడి ఫ్రమ్ బాయ్స్ బాయ్స్ నుంచి ఎవరు లేరా హర్ష హర్షలు ఇద్దరు ఉన్నారు హర్ష ఆదిత్య ఏమ్మా మాట్లాడట్లేదు ఎవరు లేరా హలో ఏరు బాయ్స్ ఎవరు మాట్లాడట్లేదు
రెడ్యూసింగ్ స్టెప్ సైజ్
అది దేని ద్వారా అడాప్ట్ టు డెల్టా మాడ్యులేషన్ నేను అదే అడుగుతున్నా బాయ్స్ టు రిమూవ్ ఆర్ టు రెడ్యూస్ దట్ స్లో పవర్ లో డిస్టార్షన్ ఆర్ గ్రానులర్ నాయిస్ by using adaptive delta modulation punishment ichest the boys andarkine evaru maatladatla d3 venkatesh unnava d
yes ma'am
adaptive delta modulation use chesi slow power load distortion granular noise రెడ్యూస్ చేస్తాం అవునా కదా So in this adaptive delta modulation, the key feature in the how to adapt that step size. If that is error voltage is more positive, step size is increased in positive direction 2 times or 3 times. If that is error is in more negative, we can decrease the step size in negative direction 2 times or 3 times to reduce that error voltage. Am I? Emma? So this is about adaptive delta modulation. So another one is a continuously variable slope over slope delta modulation. In this one, in previous in delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation, the synchronization is necessary. But in this continuously variable slope delta modulation, there is no need of synchronization. Here, by using that one, how to overcome that slope overload distortion at the same way granular noise also. Okay. Next class.
Ma'am, screen share out lena.
Screen pettaledam mane na. Just cheptunna. Already enni explain chesesanu ga.
Yes ma'am.
Avani telisini note chesukunnaru ga.
Yes ma'am.
Okay. Next class we will discuss about that signal to quantization noise ratio for delta modulation. Okay namma follow aithu follow avanamma idi chaala chaala important. Ippudu next topic chepthe meeku first unit aipothundi. Okay na. Just key features anni gurtu pettukondi, aa block diagrams anni pettukondi. మీకు ప్రతి క్వశ్చన్ అడిగిన బ్లాక్ డయాగ్రామ్ హావ్ టు రైట్ దట్ కీ పాయింట్స్ రాస్తే సరిపోతుంది. ఏమా సరే
ఓకే
ఓకేనా
ఓకే మ్యామ్
ఓకే థాంక్యూ ఆల్
థాంక్యూ మ్యామ్
థాంక్యూ
థాంక్యూ మ్యామ్
థాంక్యూ అండి.